this is not a choice between dealing with the epidemic or dealing with the economy. We have to do both, and we have to do them successfully. And the question really is, over time, given what we know and what we don't know, including, for example, the uncertainty about the degree to which antibody being present actually confers resistance to illness, that is something that is not well established for this virus as yet. Nevertheless, we do know a lot that could help us in beginning to plan for reopening in progressive and limited ways, different aspects of the economy. For example, with a respiratory virus, we know it is spread by droplets of various sizes. Some are visible, some are invisible, some may be so tiny that they could be aerosolized. With the case of SARS-CoV-2, we don't know exactly the proportion in each of those sizes, but it's pretty clear it's spread the same way many other respiratory viruses are spread. So what does this mean in terms of risk? We know that having people close to one another is a risk. That's why you separate people. We know that having many people together is a risk. If each person that you might encounter at random has a 2% chance of being infected, bring 10 of those people together with you in a room, you've got more than a 1 in 5 chance that somebody in the room is carrying that infection and could spread it to others. How long are you together? The duration of interaction, that affects the likelihood of spread. What are you doing during the interaction? Are you just sitting quietly and eating, or are you cheering at a sporting event or shouting or singing in a choir? And finally, what's the physical environment like? What's the layout? What are the degrees of protection, the separations, perhaps the use of air purification, germicidal ultraviolet, and other mechanisms? So right now, it is not too soon for every sector in the economy, whether you're a university, a school, a workplace, a factory, any gathering spot, to begin to think through, given what we know and taking advantage of what we will learn, what would be our best practices today for beginning to approach a more nearly normal way of interacting. That's a part of coping with both the economy and the epidemic that I believe could use a great deal more concerted attention from leadership across the entire spectrum of enterprise in our country.